my way of saying good afternoon in the language of saxophone. This wonderful instrument, the saxophone, was invented by a man named Adolf Sax. And Adolf Sax had no idea this instrument would become the great jazz instrument it has become. He had in mind a classical instrument. He said, well, down low, you can sound like a cello. It's made of brass, even though it's a woodwind because it has a reed, it's made of brass. So if you want, it can sound like a brass instrument. And of course it is a woodwind. Now Mr. Sax had no idea that in the 1940s, it would ever do this. He never imagined that in the 1950s, styles would change, and that same tune would sound like this. He certainly never heard in his imagination John Coltrane playing something like this. never did he imagine rock and roll in the 50s. What he had in mind was an instrument that would play classical music. Now this, of course, is the alto saxophone. I started with the sopranino saxophone. These instruments are in the key of E-flat. This is the current family of saxophones that we now play. Mr. Sax invented two families of saxophones. One in the key of F and C to be played in the symphony orchestras of his time in the 1840s and 1850s. The other family in the key of E-flat and B-flat to be played in the military bands of that time. That's what we have remaining now. So this is the E-flat sopranino. Nino means little one. And soprano means high little saxophone. And the alto saxophone, also in E-flat, is exactly, it doesn't matter, if you unbent this and it was straight or bent, it's twice as long as the E-flat sopranino. During the First World War, we think the GIs brought over the soprano saxophone, and someone got the idea that instead of just the clarinet in a Dixieland band, the soprano saxophone could also be used. And so the saxophone gradually became an quote-unquote American instrument. Actually, it was invented in Belgium and first displayed in France. Adolf Sax, when he was a young man, fell down a flight of stairs, drank some sulfuric acid, and swallowed a needle. When he grew up, he invented the saxophone. I think that Adolf Sax would have been thrilled to hear this piece we're going to play by David Maslanka. I think it is what he had in mind, and he would be very, very happy to hear it. And that concludes Saxophone 101.
Thank you. Thank you.